Did you always think he'd go into music? Was that always the path for him?
Not really, because he was sort of, because he was an academic person as well, so he had many talents, and I think he wanted initially to be a history teacher, so no, not really.
Richey wasn't the best guitarist, but he does make a lot of noise on stage.
I never had a band that said anything to me when I was young, and at least we've seen something now. We don't want to do anything that's been done before. You know, we don't want to. What we aspire to is nowhere near the band wants to aspire to. She overdosed on life.
Yeah. And no one's been as good since.
No one can ever fuck as good as Marilyn.
Few other bands in recent rock history have courted so much controversy and publicity as the Manic Street Preachers.
Street Preachers.
The Manic Street Preachers.
Street Preachers.
Street Preachers.
Manic Street Preachers.
I think we're just like, just typical of the way rock music has got to go.
When Richard was on Top of the Pops in 92, you have to remember that was 20 years ago, it was the beginnings of the band really, and he was really excited at that time that that they were going to become a successful British band, and I think he really enjoyed the success at that point.
Richey's lyrics were becoming unbelievably erudite and internalised. The ferocity of his mind, you know, was just coming out in these amazing words.
I'm an architect, they call me a butcher.
I am an architect, they call me a butcher. I am a pioneer, they call me primitive.
I think it's just the manifestation of Richey's, maybe his disintegration, was just unbelievable artistry.
There had been dramatic happenings or episodes before he went missing, which are well documented.
He felt very sensitive and found it difficult, you know, to tolerate distress in situations, I suppose.
We said to him, you could just write lyrics and design and do artwork, and if you don't want to come out and play, you know, that's just the way we do it. But he was determined to come back in it full time, really.
British police are anxious to find Manic Street Preachers guitarist Richey James, who has been missing for the past 2 weeks. Richey has not been seen since he left a hotel in London on the morning of the 1st of February.
I knocked on the door in the morning, he wasn't there, so I called Martin, our manager, what do I do? And we talked and talked and I talked to Nick about it on the phone, and we just all decided that he just really didn't want to go to America and he'd turn up in 3 days, you know, he'd just done a runner basically, you know.
At the weekend, his car was found abandoned at the Sevenbridge services. It's now been returned by police to his parents' home in Blackwood.
It just seems that the stress is getting a little bit too much for Richard at this time.
Well, I think with the sightings, they were very a man busking in a street, someone walking off into the sunset with a guitar. I always knew they weren't real, to be honest. And I think people just like to get involved, and maybe they genuinely did think they saw him.
Nicky Wire told Six Music there's even the possibility they may still use some of his unpublished work.
There are a lot of lyrics he left us.
You know, over the years there's been myths
and rumours and sightings about Richey, and we've had to deal with all that kind of B-movie bullshit kind of thing. And here we were with just these words that Richey typed on his own typewriter.
The words just kind of transported me back and to why we were such an amazing band as when it was the four of us.
I want someone to love me.
I love it, Rich.